Somewhere in the Dream of the Earth, Thomas Berry mentions that all of our cultural and religious traditions really need to go back into the origin of how they emerged in the imagination of peoples long ago. And so here we are at the time of the spring equinox. And very often what we do, especially in this country, is we celebrate the religious festivities around the time of the equinox, and that would tend to be Easter for the Christian world and Passover in the Jewish world. And that is a recounting of the human story in its some historical phase of its religious implications. And he suggests that it would be very, very helpful if we went back to the origin of those festivals, which really were festivals celebrating the seasons. So in our times, we're very detached and removed from living with the land and the implications of what the seasons meant. For us, food shows up in the supermarket, and we go to work, and we live, and what's happening on the planet as it's making its orbit around the sun is sort of invisible to us. It's just not in our way of thinking any longer. So Thomas Berry feels that by going back into the origin of what's really happening with the Earth in its movement around the sun, we connect again to what's happening outside in the natural world as life comes up out of the dark of winter, and new buds form and roots of the trees start to bring the sap up, and that's all happening, and it's spectacular, and for the most part we're unaware of it. So the tradition we have at Genesis Farm is to go back and celebrate those four turning points in the seasonal changes of the year, and to try to remember we're on a planet that's spinning on its axis so that we have day and night, as well as moving in this huge orbit around the sun, and the conditions of light and heat that we experience on the temperate zone where we are because of that larger event that's happening, so that we're more in touch with that, and it gives us a greater appreciation of the awesomeness of what that means. So we, for 20 some years now, we have been celebrating these four seasonal changes at the farm and using them as a way to reconnect consciously with the land there and the forest there and the streams and soils and what's happening. Can we reinterpret spring and renewal in a way that connects us in our intention to be more conscious and to live more consciously? And part of the reason why Genesis Farm focuses so much on using the universe story, the evolution of the universe as a spiritual as well as a physical development, is because when we realize that we are the universe in the form of a human thinking this question and feeling these feelings, we can understand we have an identity that is identical with the whole Earth and universe. And if you are a person of faith and you believe in God, then obviously this is all part of revelation. So the work of Thomas Berry, Catholic priest, Brian Swim, a mathematical cosmologist, and a host of other people. But here they are in our own tradition, and we can pull their writings out, and they are profoundly spiritual in their implications. But that kind of study is, it's hard to do if you just want to live your life as business as usual, and making time for that instead of TV or this, that, or the other thing has to be a commitment. And I think that's a spiritual discipline. That, it's there if we choose it.